Christ our Lord to earth descended, our full homage to thee, man. Christ our Lord to earth descended, our full homage to let all mortal flesh keep silence.
Now, O come, Emmanuel, and ransom captive Israel that mourns in lonely exile.
It seems that the human race is forever at the same crossroads. Times may appear to change, but men don't. And always just over the horizon, or rumbling barely beneath the surface, men are waiting to plunder, kill, and conquer each other afresh and anew. And the more starkly adverse the circumstances, the deeper the realization comes to us of our need for a Messiah. The darker the times, the more fervent our longing for a Redeemer, for a Messiah who can save us from each other, for a Redeemer who can buy us back from ourselves. The melody may change, but the song is forever the same. O come, Emmanuel.
Reuben, my husband, why are you so sad?
Another day. It's always the same. The Philistines come and take another lamb. The others come in our marketplace and steal our grain and our money. The roads echo again with the sounds of the boots of the conquerors. When will it ever end? Will we ever have peace?
He will come. The Messiah will come. And he will bring peace and righteousness.
Yeah. He'll come. But will he come in time for this farm to be given to young Caleb, as it was, is given to me? Will he come in time to protect our little Sarah? Or will her life too end here? Will he come in time to protect our dreams and our hopes? Or will they too be trampled in the dust?
He has promised, and he will come.
But I needed him today. I needed him in the pasture this morning. He was needed in the village this afternoon. We need him here tonight. To protect us from the chariots that rumble in the distance. We need him. We need the Messiah.
He will come. He has to come. There is no other hope. And we have no other answer. And there is no other promise. The Messiah will come.
Unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and thou shalt call his name Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. And of the increase of his government and peace there shall be no end. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this.
The promise had been made, but the centuries were to roll by, bringing with them a long succession of conquerors instead of a Messiah. Assyrians, Babylonians, Persians, Greeks, and finally the Romans. The promise, made so long ago, had been passed along, whispered in captivity, shouted in defiance, lived by, hoped for, at times almost forgotten, to be lifted up again somewhere. And now, suddenly, in the fullness of time, God keeps his promise. He comes into our world.
Hey! Wonder! I wonder what's going on in there! Oh, Wonder, over there in that stable! Does anybody know what's going on in there? Do you know what's going on? Doesn't anybody know? What's going on? What's going on in there?
What's going on? What's going on?
What's going on?
From the fields nearby, we were watching our sheep in the night, when suddenly we saw an angel in the sky, and we trembled at the glorious sight. Then the angel said to us, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you tidings of great joy.
From the sea. like I had done before. And oh, my mind was so confused by the things that filled my head. My heart could feel a settled peace with the words the angel said.
Glory, glory, glory. ladies and gentlemen, we present the second half, part two, of Thou Shalt Call His Name, Jesus.
The God who makes promises to men has come to keep them. The God who promised us that he would send us a Redeemer has sent his Son to us.
But the chastisement of our peace is upon him. He was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. And by his stripes we are healed. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way. But the Lord hath laid on him the iniquity of us all.
counselor.
The God who can help us.
Mighty God.
The God who is with us now.
He is the everlasting Father.
And the God who is working for us.
He is the Prince of Peace.
He has come to us to be all he has been named. And it is at Christmas that all the names he has been given and all those which grow out of our hope and our dream are gathered into one name which we worship. Thou shalt call his name Jesus.
But names for him are just words, ladders of nouns and adjectives we raise to reach him with our hearts, this one who is beyond our grasp or comprehension. For when we have spoken the finest words we know, and when our minds are filled with our highest thoughts, when we have dreamed our noblest dreams, he is all that we can speak, and all that is yet unspoken. He is all that we can think, and all that is still unthought. He is all that we can name, and all that we leave nameless. This is the God who has come to us.
More wonderful than my heart can.
worship is a response to his coming to us. In our search for symbols and ways to recognize and adore him, perhaps no setting is more graphic or speaks more of his coming to us than that of darkness and light. Isaiah said, the people who have walked in darkness have seen a great light. John said, and the light shined in the darkness. And Paul said, but God, who commanded the light to shine out of darkness, has shined in our hearts to give us the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus.
For a moment, let us imagine that we are sitting in darkness. Darkness which blots out all the smiles of our loved ones. Darkness which symbolizes the evils of the day in which we live. Darkness which reminds us that we must have locks and keys and policemen and fences because men still go out to rob and to kill. Darkness which enslaves our children with drugs and habits which will eventually destroy their lives. Darkness which reminds us that it spawns all the wickedness and evil which men so readily embrace. Darkness which reminds us that we too live in a world which desperately needs the coming of the light.
Just one little light in the darkness, just one little flicker of light, just one small glimmer of brightness, dispelling the darkness of night. But oh, what God did.
Well, once again, it is light, and light has come to us. And we have seen just one flickering candle come into our darkness and drive it away. This season, let us also rejoice in this life-giving and life-bringing proclamation that Jesus came into the darkness of our world and brought it light. Tonight, let's just thank the Lord for this marvelous gift. Our Father, we thank you for sending the light to us when we are alone in the darkness. As surely as we have seen the light enter this dark room, Jesus came into the blackness of the world and brought light. We come again before you this Christmas asking you to come into the deep recesses of our hearts where fear has brought darkness. Bring the courage of a resplendent light where guilt has cast its gloomy shadows. Give to us the radiance of your forgiveness where sadness has eclipsed the light of day. Please shine again the sunrise of your love. Brighten our pathways, illuminate our lives, and warm us with your presence. Oh, guide us with that holy star, and call us with angelic light. In the name of him who brought to us the brightness of Christmas, Jesus, amen.
Christmas is a festival of awe, a worship of the God who came, the wonderful God, breathing with a startled cry the cold night air, the counselor of the ages, knowing for this time only his mother's breast, the mighty God, carried in the crook of a carpenter's arm, the everlasting Father, only 3 hours old, the Prince of Peace, his kingdom in a stall. God has come into this world. Thou shalt call his name Jesus. Would you all please stand to join us in singing Joy to the World?
Okay.
Stand by just to use the yellow mic in case that doesn't work.
What this musical has done tonight is to lift up Jesus. I just sent the message to him to not leave. I think maybe we could get him to sing that finale number one more time.